I'm here south of the St. Lucia estuary, what used to be the Mfolozi River mouth. Bird life is incredible. Seems that there's barbers playing in the shallow water. You can hear them gulping every now and then. But if you're a bird enthusiast, this is where you should come. Huge variety of birds frolicking in the shallow water here. Yeah, it's at Fallon Bay. It's got two gullies, the first one right here, and then about 250, 300 meters around the bend, there's another one. That's the one that I will go and fish just now. Tide is pushing. Just waiting for the whale watching to launch. Then I'll make the walk. But to walk the hour from Ingwe Beach to here to try and target the non-fish, I don't think it's worth it. Apparently if you do get shad here, they're very skittish. You don't want to land your spoon in between the shelf. You want the shoal, you want to cast over it onto the sandbank and bring the spoon softly into the shoal, otherwise the shoal scatters. If I look at the clear water, I can understand why the people claim that. This charter getting ready to launch for a whale watching trip. Here's the lucky people that's gonna ride God's roller coaster today, having the most fun that you can have with your clothes on. Werner giving the safety briefings, telling the people what to expect and how to hold on, what happens in the case of emergency. Luckily, over the past 20 years, I don't know of an incident where an emergency has taken place. Don't take chances, don't go out and see the conditions that is not favorable. Done it so many times. So humble, so much respect for the ocean. Absolutely a must do. When you visit St. Lucia estuary during the winter months, from June to December, whale watching. The 250s, two 250 Suzukis. Like Jeremy Clarkson would say, having a gentleman moment here. It's incredible to hear those powerful machines roar into action. Launchmaster today for whale watching is none else Wiseman himself, and getting ready. Now that it's light, one can see the washing machine conditions that is happening there. But like all other boats before, Berno will probably go slow and take it head on. One at a time. Powerful tractor is pushing out some diesel fumes, getting the heavy boat into the ocean. There, Advantage Charter 1 is floating, looking for traction. Boat is finding traction. Werner is starting to watch, check it, counting the sets. Wish I had a zoom lens to zoom in on the skipper so you guys can see how intense they are when they count those sets. It's anything between 20 and 30 seconds per set. Werner is right there in the washing machine. As I said, he will probably take it slow, one at a time. The 250 is pushing him right through the foamies. He's going right across the sandbank. Shortest route. That's a nice climb over that foamy. It's massive. And there it goes sideways on the shoulder, running north. I used the word massive, sorry. it's immensely confusing, the different directions the waves are coming. But yeah, as I said, keep it slow, take them one at a time. Werner's going right north. I thought he was going to turn quick over the sandbag, but he's going right north. That was a big foamy that he climbed over there, but you can't see it on the video. These people are really having a roller coaster ride today. But a slow one. Another foamy right head on, and there he's out in the ocean. Well done, Berno.
Thanks to St. Lucia Tours and Charters for sponsoring this video, and to Captain and Skipper Berno Philipson for the great photos that he supplies on a daily basis. Berno, I've seen you launch many times. Every time is a masterpiece. But your photographs, my friend, is out of this world. People, this is a must. Once in a lifetime must excursion that you have to go on. It's like turtle tours, watching the turtles nesting. Whale watching is the same. See a whale spy hopping. Looking ahead to find out what is going on. Looking around to see what's happening above the surface. What more can you ask? Come on. As the marketing machine exclaims, the most fun you can have with your clothes on. I call it riding God's roller coaster. It is absolutely an incredible experience. Do it.
Mapalon, the second highest windblown sand dune in the world. It's called windblown because you can see all over the wind is blowing the sand into little minor minute sand dunes. So over the last, they claim 25,000 years, the wind kept on blowing the sand against the obstacles. Vegetation kept on growing, wind kept on blowing, vegetation kept on growing, and we got a windblown sand dune. Last time I checked, it was roughly about 180 meters high. I'll have to go and re-verify my facts, but that's roughly around about there. The highest sand dunes, vegetated sand dunes, is Fraser Island, also a World Heritage Site. Mapalon Bay that everybody is talking about. Water is nice, but there's people spinning, fishing with bait. I just don't see any fish coming out. I don't see any fish in the water. I don't see why we have to walk this far. I don't see it as paradise. I just see it as another beach. No different than Main Beach in Lucia Estuary. Just as much sidewashes. Maybe if you had a slide on the mackerel here, mackerel on the slide would have been better. This is the second trip for the day. Surf looks much better now than this morning. Boat refueled, everything ready. Captain Berno going to do the safety briefing again. And Pardet digging this beach up in frustration. We're gonna hitch a ride with the tracker back home so she can get water and food. I can recharge my batteries. And be back in time for the Snook Derby to land, I hope. Skibo Club Launchmaster in control of Landini's Mobis. And Safety briefing is over, indemnity forms are signed. Here the 250's raw. Suzuki 4-stroke. Hang on, guys! I call it God's roller coaster. Bernie lying here right in the bay. Some big sets coming through. He has to wait for them to come through, he has to count them out. And he's gonna start pushing towards the sandbank now. He's going to go north. There's a nice flat opening north. There you go, counted nicely, Berno. Jump that foamy. Whoa! What a nice one. Turning into that curly and there's he out. Another one. Well done, Berno. Another launch. Perfect launch. Captain Berno getting ready for the third trip today. Unique way of turning the boat around. Getting it in line for the next launch. Hooking up to the push bar. Hooking the push bar up, as you've seen many times before. Okay, getting it straight. And there we go. Not yet. Crawling up to it. Counting the sets like usual. Some high ones standing up in the front there. Be waiting for them to come fill up the bay. Okay, there we go. Unhook. Motor seeking traction, trimming down. Going head on. Waiting for that foamy to come. Over. Waiting for the next one. Over, next one, over, and there's going for the cap, a little bit to the south. Oh. He's looking for a gap there, he's a little bit pushed in the corner here, but the 250s, 500 horsepower is getting him around the bend. There you go, Berno. Perfect once again. Kana cruiser coming in with a huge curler on his tail. And a foamy in front of him. taking it slow. Taking it slow, staying between the waves. Waiting for the set. But there's one pushing him from behind. No, it dissipated. Waiting for the beach to fill up with water, and there's picking up speed. Beautiful. The report, two fish caught. Next one coming in, I don't have the name. I missed cycling beach. Coming in fast, slowing down to get on the back of that curler. I wish you guys could see how big these curlers is in relation to the boats. Picking up speed, foamy in front of him, curler behind him. Riding the foamy, I think he's gonna jump it. Yes, it's coming in hot. Very little water on the beach at the moment. Slowing down, ocean commotion. Well done. Next boat coming in, already a curler on his back tail. He's waiting for the swell to pass underneath him. Riding on the back of that curler, coming right nicely over the sandbank. Push between the curler and the foamy. There's water on this beach, but he's waiting for this one in the front to dissipate. Now there's no water. And it's been pushed hard. There's the water coming, and here climax is coming. Climax is coming in hot, and nice softly landed. Nice climax. A little bit hair raisy situation here, still in the shore dump. Okay, there the tractor is picking up the tension and pulling him out of the shore dump. Can't say his name, can't identify him, I don't know all the boats. He's got a nice flat in front of him, waiting to get on the back of a curler. Guys, excuse the lingo I'm using, but this lingo that I'm using is like 40 years ago, what we called it when we were surf launching here as youngsters. I don't know what the new skippers call it. I haven't done my skipper's ticket yet. It's coming in good on the back of a foamy. And it's all the way clear to the beach too for him. It's that name of the boat that I couldn't pronounce this morning. I couldn't read it. It's that guy. He has to come in slow. Speed, putting it down hard. The boat's name is Walala. Any fish, guys? Next. Next, next, nee. Coming in on speed, looks like a Hellcat from here. Can be full thrust. Don't know, can't see the name. Coming in all over the place. Slowing down to get on the back of that curler. Ocean is not nice today, guys. But yet the people went out, they went fishing. He has to turn a little bit sideways to fit in between the back curler and the front foamy. Nicely done. Yep, it's full thrust. Coming in hot. Got some water to land on. is how a local does it. Displays it and brags about it. Full thrust with 5 kudas and 2 snook. Well done. Sir, Warren picking up speed, he's got water on the beach, he's coming in hot, having a nice jump there, nicely done Warren, oh, all the way out on the beach. In, nope, not yet, looks like it, coming in hot and fast. The sea is rough, it's all over the place. Same as Thunder Flash, but a full thrust, but a little bit more speed. Also turning a little bit sideways to fit in between the waves. John Deere Jr. Checking his rear. Waiting for the beach to fill up, picking up speed, coming in hot, nice and hot. Oh, that's a beautiful beach, right onto the dry sand. Coming in, big one, could be thunderstruck. Also you can see how it rolls on the way in. Has to fit in between that foamy and the curler behind him. I think I'm in his way here. Yeah? He's gonna probably beach over there. Coming in hot, slowing down to wait for the water on the beach. Now he's gonna punch it and there's no more place to pick up speed. Thunderstruck. Coming in. One of the smaller boats, so he's running nice. The sea chopper is not catching up with him. It's running smooth. Coming over that one, waiting for the water to fill. Looks like if I'm right in his way over here. But Jazani, hey, that's an excellent skipper, this guy. In, come over that swell, waiting for this one to dissipate. He's got it nicely made, spaced well, waiting for the water to fill up on the beach, and he's coming in hot. That's going to be a smooth landing. So one of the bigger boats, not massive, but you can see he's lying hard in the water. The sea chopper is not throwing them around, waiting on the back of that curler, riding it, slowing down, waiting for it to break away. Now he's got it nice and made. He was waiting for this one curler to break onto the beach. And he's got that foamy on his back. And he's gonna push it, punch it now. Oops. Oops. This is Viking. There Viking comes. Next one to come in. Can't see who it is. Don't know who's the next one. The lineup is pretty full here in the back. I see the launchmaster is looking for a place to put down the next boat. It will be between Busy Liz and John Deere Jr. Here she comes. Got a nice flat, waiting for that swell to pick up and wash over the sandbank. That one foamy turning south. Yenalo is coming in, Yenalo. Waiting for the water to fill up. That's the advantages of a small boat, as you can maneuver. There you go, Yenalo. Next one coming in, hanging back on the back line, pushing hard. Can't see the name yet. Huge foamy in front of him. And a nice curler standing up on his ass. Also doing it sideways. Okay, he fits in nicely now. The curler on the back dissipated. This just disappeared and went away. Oop. He's pushing over this one and he's coming onto this one. Hard and fast. Ish. That's a hard landing. Capre Diem. Okay guys, that concludes the launching and the beaching of the boats for the day one of the St. Lucia Ski Boat Club Snook Derby 2019. The results of the day's catches and the weigh-in will be done on another video when I get the official results from the Ski Boat Club. I cannot steal the glamour away from them. Now we're going to see what is happening with sardine netting on the south coast. As we speak, this happened. Sardine netting at Manzamtoti, as it happens.
Net of sardines for 2019. Well done, Jace.